Hi everyone. In this video, I'll be showing you how to set up and integrate GA Connector with the WordPress Contact Form 7 plugin. First, we'll install the GA Connector plugin. You can download the plugin from gaconnector.com/download/WordPress or by clicking the link below this video. For now, just save the plugin zip file to your desktop or another handy location. Once you've downloaded the plugin, log into your WordPress admin panel and navigate to Plugins, then Add New. In the next screen, click Upload Plugin and browse for that GA Connector plugin zip file that you just downloaded. When you're ready, click Install Now. When it completes, click Activate Plugin. Next, we're going to configure your Contact Form 7 based web form to work with the extension and to tie those analytics to your form submissions. For the purposes of this tutorial, we'll assume that you've already installed the Contact Form 7 plugin. So first, using the left-hand side navigation within your WordPress admin panel, hover over Contact, then click Contact Forms. Locate the name of the form that you want to connect to GA Connector and click to open it for editing. Now, look below this video for the Contact Form 7 hidden fields code. It should look something like this. Copy that code to your clipboard. Then, in the Form tab of your form editor, paste that code in at the very bottom after all of the other code used in your form and click Save. Awesome! Your form is now connected to GA Connector, and each form submission will now also include the analytics data for the customer who submitted it. Now, before we wrap up this video and move on to configuring your CRM, let's test and make sure that the connection between the GA Connector plugin and the form is set up properly. To do this, we'll use the default Mail tab functionality in Contact Form 7 to view the data collected in the form submission. So first, navigate back to your WordPress admin console, and once again open up Contact, then Contact Forms. Click the name of the form that you want to edit to open it. Then, click the Mail tab. You probably already configured your send to email address when you set up the Contact Form 7, but you're welcome to make any changes to it at this point. Now, to configure the emails to include your extended GA Connector analytics data, you'll need to paste another snippet of code into the message body window. Again, you'll find this code snippet below the video. It should look like this. So we'll copy this code to our clipboard, and then just paste it at the very bottom of the message body window after any other text in that window. Finally, just scroll down and click Save. Now that we've configured the form, let's run a test. So first, I'm clearing my browser cache to get rid of any existing cookies so that the form will see me as a fresh visitor. Now, I'm filling out the form with sample data and clicking Send to submit the form. Let's click over to my email account to look at the data. And there it is. You can see that my form submission contains the extended analytics data appended to the bottom with the first and last click referral information, browser, geographic location, campaign, channel, and more. So that's it. If your test was successful, then the GA Connector plugin is now collecting data and appending it to your form submissions. If you have any questions, be sure to refer to our knowledge base and FAQs, and don't hesitate to reach out to our friendly support team.